Hi everyone, my name is Sam and I'm a PhD student of Caroline Faust at the Laboratory of Microbial Systems Biology. And today I will be giving a brief talk to accompany my poster, Fast and Flexible Analysis of Linked Microbiome Data with MACO. Here you're looking at a photo of human tooth plaque. We see here a purple Corynebacterium and in green Streptococcus. Corynebacterium is a strictly anaerobic species, but it's very good at sticking to teeth. In contrast, Streptococcus cannot stick to teeth, but it is aerobic. In fact, it's so aerobic that it's able to create an anaerobic environment, allowing the Corynebacterium species to survive. And there are many biological interactions like it that are hugely relevant to ecosystem structure and function. So microbial association networks are a way to predict these important biotic interactions from count data or sequencing data. And you see an example of such a network on the right. We have here the circles representing different species of eukaryotes, prokaryotes or viruses. And then the lines between them, the edges, these represent either co-presence or mutual exclusion. So in general, these nodes tend to represent taxa, but they can also represent important metadata. And the edges represent associations, and those can be inferred using a range of different statistical approaches. However, there's a big problem with these microbial association networks, which is that they tend to be very inaccurate. Here we're looking at a figure from Weiss et al, where they used population models to simulate different interaction networks, and then used these network inference methods to see if they could find the simulated interactions back. And if this was the case, then these network inference methods would be in the star area, so the top left. This would mean that they have both high sensitivity and high precision. But this is generally not the case. Microbial association networks tend to be in either the bottom left or the bottom right region, meaning that they have either high precision or high sensitivity, but pretty much never both. Because these microbial association networks are so inaccurate, it's necessary to include additional information to properly analyze them and use them to design new hypotheses and additional experiments. However, actually analyzing all this data together is not a trivial issue. Microbial association networks can be very large, especially if you have multiple of them, and the amount of metadata that can be included with them can also be significant. As a result, it can pay off to work with a dedicated database structure rather than analyzing everything from memory, which is normally done. And this is where MACO comes in, because it facilitates the use of Neo4j graph databases. Why would you want to use such a graph database? Well, it's a really intuitive method to actually store linked biological data. So what exactly is a graph database? Well, if we have a relational database, a more traditional type of databases, these store data as tables, meaning that we would have a table with source nodes, target nodes, and the weight of the association between them. A graph database, on the other hand, stores data as nodes and relationship between those nodes. In this Neo4j example, we can see that we have two people, Justin and Aaron, which are both represented as a node, and we have an article. One of them wrote the article and the other read the article. One of the core components of the MACO software is a data schema based on the National Cancer Institute thesaurus, meaning it uses a standardized language to describe these relationships between things. And here you're looking at this schema. We have a taxon in the center, which can have different properties, like its taxonomic assignments, but also the specimens or samples it was found in, and indirectly the experiments it was part of, as well as any other type of property that it may have. And one of the main benefits of using a database schema like this is that it's possible to use to have reusable queries. Neo4j databases are queried with Cypher. And this is a pattern-based query language, meaning that if you draw a little pattern of the type of data that you want to find, it's relatively simple to translate this into a query that looks like it. This is unlike SQL queries, which may require significant table joining operations, for example. So, of course, a presentation of a new software method isn't complete without a showcase showing what you can actually do with this software method. And that's what I'm showing you here. We have here on the left an overview of the different types of bacterial genera that are capable of carrying out conversions from different substrates to propionate. And what I was interested in is seeing if in the association network I could find associations between species that could work together to actually carry out these reactions. So what you see on the right, the colors correspond to the different genera and the reactions that they are carrying out. And the connected bars show whether they actually had an association. The bar plot at the top shows how many of these associations were found. In addition to working with interesting metadata, like the metabolite data, we can also use Cypher to quite easily look for interesting patterns, like motifs. Motifs are specific combinations of relationships or edges that form shapes that may be more or less overrepresented. So this is a very quick initial exploratory study where I looked at the abundance of cliques, 3- and 4-node cliques, with specific weight combinations in 60 unique microbial association networks. And what I could find quite easily is that the animal-associated networks have a lot more of these 4 clique motifs than any of the other categories. Part of this is simply because there were a lot more animal networks, they are overrepresented in the database, but compared to the 3-node cliques, they are about equally abundant, which is not the case for any of the other microbial networks. So to conclude, the interpretation of microbial association networks improves from the inclusion of additional data. And graph databases are an intuitive way of actually working with this data, both for storing it, but also for their analysis. The Mako software tool that I developed facilitates the speedy adoption of Neo4j graph databases by rapidly populating these databases and by supporting reproducible downstream analysis. Thank you for listening. I'd like to acknowledge my supervisor, Caroline Faust, as well as the rest of the Lab of Microbial Systems Biology. And if you're interested in trying out the software, you can find it online at the GitHub link. Everything is available under an Apache 2.0 license. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me during the conference and I'll be happy to answer them.